Flagella are locomotory organelles of protozoans, some protozoans and prokaryotes. Flagella consists of basal granule and axial filament called axonim. Okay. Axonim arises from basal granule. Axonim shows 9+2 arrangement of microtubules. Two central singlets are enclosed by inner sheath. 9 peripheral doublets form a cylinder between inner sheath and outer sheath. Now continue. Each microtubules of pair are connected by inter doublet bridge. Next point. Microtubule A is connected to inner sheath. This spoke is there now. You can write up to here. Microtubule A is connected to inner sheath with a radial spoke. This is A, this is B like this. Otherwise, this is A, B. A is connected to inner sheath with radial spoke. Microtubule A is connected to inner sheath with a radial spoke. Okay, next point. It has Dynein arms towards neighbor doublet. Dynein, Dynein. Dynein arms towards neighbor doublet. Comma, Dynein arms creates sliding movement. Praveen RSB, close your video. Sliding movement. Okay. Next point. Flagella arises from basal granule basal granule in the ectoplasm. In the ectoplasm. Okay. Basal granule is a cylindrical body. Basal granule is cylindrical body formed by 9 triplets. Formed by 9 triplets below the pellicle. Pellicle. P-E-L-L-I-C-L-E. Pellicle. Next point. These triplets continue as doublets into axonium. Doublets into axonium. Next point. Basal body is connected to plasma membrane or nucleus. With rootlets. Okay, basal body is connected to plasma membrane or nucleus. From that basal body, there is development of this flagellum. Next heading, cilia. Cilia are short hair like structure. Present all over the surface of cell or some specific regions in ciliate protozoans. Next point. Primitive forms like holotrix, HOLOTRICHS, holotrix, have cilia have cilia in all surface of cell on all surfaces of the cell. Example, paramecium. In peritrichs, cilia are present. Cilia are present cilia are present as peristomial. Peristomial, that is at sides. Example, verticella, VORTICELLA, verticella. Cilia shows 9+2 arrangements. Cilia shows 9+2 arrangements with two single central microtubules, two singlets central microtubules and 9 peripheral doublet microtubules. Next point, the base of cilia, basal body is there, not that base of cilia is kinetosome. Which develops into cilia. Which develops into cilia. This is about cilia and flagella. Function of this cilia and flagella is locomotion. Locomotion, that's all. Next, last one. Nucleus is singular. Nuclei is doubler. This nucleus is very important part of the cell, you know. Here, when we saw the flowchart of the parts of the cell, we divided the nucleus from cytoplasm in protoplasm. What is protoplasm? Protoplasm means except cell membrane, remaining totally it is called as a protoplasm. Then in that protoplasm, cytoplasm plus organelles, they are separated. Then this one is what? Nucleus. Nucleus is very important part. It is a spherical structure which controls all life processes of the cell. It is a spherical body present in cell, and this is the major part that controls all activities of cell. All activities, whatever the activity, whether it is a living characteristic like metabolism, growth, whatever that is, all life activities are under the control of nucleus. Because why nucleus is controlling all other activities means, nucleus is said to be heart of the cell that has DNA. Due to presence of genetic material in the nucleus, nucleus is responsible to coordinate all the parts of the cell. So it is largest, most dynamic cell organelle. Largest and most dynamic cell organelle. This is a very important. Without nucleus, cell will not function all its characteristics. All the functions of cell are performed by the nucleus only. In introduction of this chapter, I told you who discovered the nucleus. Anyone tell me who discovered the nucleus? Kinetosome, which develops into cilia. Yes, Freeman. Very good. Yeah, that was discovered by a scientist known Brown. Robert Brown is a scientist who discovered nucleus first. Okay, and later this nucleus was stained. Stained means some coloring agents are added. Some coloring agents are added, and inside the nucleus there is a structure called as chromatin. CHROMATIN. Chromatin was found. Chromatin material is the structure of DNA which is present inside the nucleus that has a complexity of proteins and DNA. Okay, here this chromatin was discovered by a scientist called Fleming. Fleming is a scientist who stained the nucleus and observed the presence of chromatin material, chromatin threads. DNA along with proteins, it will form chromatin. That was observed by the Fleming. But this chromatin is present in all eukaryotic cells except mature RBC. Chromatin is present in all eukaryotic cells except mature RBC. Red blood corpuscles are matured, means in that red blood corpuscles, mature red blood corpuscles, there is no chromatin. Remaining all cells have this one. Especially in that plants also, especially in phloem, is there na? Phloem, that phloem parts also have sieve elements. In that sieve elements also there is no chromatin. Chromatin is absent in mature RBC and sieve elements of plants. Remaining all have this chromatin. Chromatin is DNA wrapped with histone proteins. Okay, and some more scientists conducted some experiments on some algae like Acetabularia and found the function and heredity role of that nucleus. That scientist name is Hammerling. Hammerling is a scientist. He studied studied an algae named Acetabularia. Acetabularia is an algae. On Acetabularia, he conducted some experimental studies. With the help of the studies, what he did on Acetabularia, he found hereditary role of nucleus. Hereditary. What is hereditary role? What is heredity? Transmission of a character from one generation to next generation. Transmission of a character from one generation to next generation, not another generation. You may say transfer of a character from one generation to another generation, or like that you may say. Heredity means transmission of a character from one generation to next generation. That is correct. Why? Because another generation means, what is another? One generation is there. Next generation, there is a transmission. From that to next generation, successive or proceeding generation, there is a transmission. Another generation means from this to this, or this to this, like that there will be no clarity. So heredity is transmission of character from one generation to next generation. Parents to progeny, or parents to offspring. Okay, like that, this Hamerling is a scientist who studied the role of nucleus in an algae named Acetabularia, and he found the hereditary role. Hereditary role means transmission of characters. You know how characters are being transmitted. Characters are transmitted with the help of DNA. DNA is responsible for transfer of characters from one generation to next generation. How DNA carries? DNA has nucleotide sequence that is responsible for the transmission of character or transfer of character from one generation to next generation. Where that DNA is present? Especially genomic DNA. Genomic DNA is present inside the nucleus. So when the nucleus is dividing during cell division, and that nucleus is carrying the DNA from one generation to next generation, when that DNA is carried by nucleus, at the same time, there is a transfer of character from one generation to next generation. And based on the presence of number of nuclei in cell, based on number of nuclei. Usually, some cells may have single nucleus, but they may have multi-nucleus. Some may have multi-nucleus. Based on the number of nucleus present in a cell, cells are said to be uninucleate cell, binucleate cell, and multi-nucleate or phenocytic cell. First one, uninucleate cell. Uninucleate cells means only one nucleus is present per one cell. Each cell has single nucleus. That type of cell called as uninucleate cell. These are most common types. All cells are, most common type of cells are uninucleate. Then second one is binucleate cells. Binucleate cells have two nuclei. Two nuclei are present in each cell. Two nuclei in each cell. If a cell has, in a cell, if the cell has two nuclei, then it is called as a binucleate condition. This binucleate condition is seen in paramecium, M-O-E-C-I-U-M. Paramecium is one example, and some fungi. Some fungi. They have binucleate, and apatum of anther. answer. In flower, male reproductive part is there, now which is called as anther. In that male reproductive part, anther, there is presence of a type of tissue called as a tapetum tissue or a tapetum cell. In that tapetum cells, there is presence of two nuclei. That is binucleate cell. Next one is multinucleate or phenocytic cell. Multinucleate or phenocytic cells with more than two nuclei. These cells with more than two nuclei. If a cell has more than two nuclei, then it is called as phenocytic cell or multinucleate cell. That is seen in some algae like Wacheria. Wacheria is an algae that has a phenocytic cell, and there are some fungi like Rhizopus. Mucor, Rhizopus is a type of fungi. Mucor is a type of fungi. Okay, that has multinucleate condition. Some tapetum cells also have multinucleate condition, but majorly Wacheria, Rhizopus, and Mucor. Okay, they has multinucleate condition. Okay, time is almost complete. Just we have 1 minute. Okay, this is the largest cell organelle I told you, na. Write the dimensions of that nucleus. It occupies 15 to 20% of mass of cell. 15 to 20% of cell is occupied by the nucleus. And size is different from cell to cell. Size of the nucleus is the different from cell to cell. And now only 1 minute. Okay, I will continue next class. No need to worry. Suppose some cells have central nucleus. At the middle of the cell, there may be presence of nucleus in some cells. That is normal, like meristematic cells. But in some cells, a large central vacuole is there, cytoplasm and nucleus is present at side. I think when we are studying with that protoplasm, cytoplasm, there I told you. Some cells have nucleus at center, like this, no problem. But some cells have a large vacuole, but cytoplasm, rim of cytoplasm and nucleus at peripheral point. That is called as a primordial utricle condition. Primordial utricle condition, and this shape is spherical, but some cells they may have different shape also, like cells like WBC, it is elliptical shape, and that also, this also I will teach again. I will repeat in tomorrow class. Okay, time is less than 1 minute.